All right, this is from Reba Gwirl. The song's called Say Goodbye. Practicing this upstairs. We need a third part. What should we do? So. So sometimes I just have these default little things when I'm practicing. Once in a while they get turned into tunes. Case in point. Yeah, let's do that. All right. These are both, well, okay, this is a banjo. Arguable point.
Whatever you are.
So what is this?
This is a cello banjo.
And this is?
It's a banjo, guitar banjo.
Yeah, guitar banjo.
Guitar banjo. This is an octave lower
than a regular banjo.
So instead of the high, lonesome sound of bluegrass, it's the low, convivial sound of the cello banjo. As you can plainly hear. This is a bonus track from Michael's album.
That's right. If you were a Kickstarter backer, and you got this track.
How many Kickstarter partners? Oh, never. All right, we got some Kickstarter folks here. Thank you.
Dark and creepy Bill Monroe songs.
Thank you.
appeared on Tony's Double Banjo Bluegrass Spectacular album. And it was the first track I ever recorded with Tony.
Yeah.
Or with Chris Thiele or with Noam McKilney. Where we were all on this track.
Yeah. It was the beginning of the Punch Brothers.
Yeah, two of us didn't make the cut.
I was very fortunate when I was 14 or 15 years old that there was a really pretty good bluegrass band that was about two blocks from the house I lived in with my parents. They were called the Moonshine Mountain Boys. I know, you chortle, I mean, exactly. Syracuse, New York, 1963, a veritable nest of bluegrass. But interestingly, these guys knew Pete Rowan. Peter Rowan was going to Colgate University, which was an hour and a half away from Syracuse, and he would come over and hang out with them and I guess pick. I never saw him there, but at the 1964 Syracuse Folk Festival, I entered a banjo contest, and Pete Rowan was my backup guitar player for that. And I think I won, as I remember it. And as I remember it, I was the only contestant. That's another story.
Did you win?
I won because there were no other contestants. So by default, I won. Anyway, that bluegrass band, the Moonshine Mountain, you were wondering, where am I going with this? But the Moonshine Mountain Boys used to do this tune, which is, I think, a J.E. Maynard tune, if I'm not mistaken. But I'd never heard it anywhere else but that. So I figured, let me do this. And then Chris Thiele, being Chris Thiele, decided, let's add an extra beat in it and make it crooked. So it's not impossible to play, but it's harder to play.
That's his fault?
Yeah, that was his deal. That was his deal. Yeah, let's add this extra beat in there. And just for penance, he has to MC the Prairie Home Companion. What a rough deal there.
This is what they talked about on the radio show.
Shall we try this?
Oh,
Chuck a Little Hill. Run Mountain Chuck a Little Hill. Run Mountain Chuck a Little Hill. There you'll get your fill. More profound lyrics I've never heard. If anyone has some deep insight, I'd like to know what it is. Great unbeknownst.
Remember that,
I think I can bring it back. Kiev.
Or we could do Danny Thomas.
Let's do that. Yeah, he's Tennessee. What is it?
It's the it's one of these confusing state named bluegrass songs. There's so many of them. This is the Blue Virginia Blues. A one chord and a three chord and it's very sophisticated for a bluegrass song.
Is everyone comfortable?
Yeah.
Can I get anyone a drink? Or
just don't. Singing one, this is made notable by the great Count Sparkula, as we like to call him. Larry Sparks. I don't know, in bluegrass we have the checkered demon of bluegrass, that's Jimmy Martin. He's also the self-proclaimed king of bluegrass. I don't know if, Larry Sparks, Count Sparkula, that's pretty good. He's got, in the 70s he had this great, Widow's Peak and kind of Pompadour and, Crushed Velvet Blazers, and he was like a real...
Draculated kind of guy.
Yeah.
I think there's a book about Lester Flatt called The Duke of Bluegrass or something like that. Yeah. All the royalty names are being taken up.
The undersecretary of...
You're the Viscount.
The Viscount, yeah. The Regent.
You're here,
ladies and gentlemen, the Viscount of Bluegrass.
You're the vicar. The vicar.
Sunday night.
Yeah, okay. I mean, we could tomorrow. We could play. I mean, we could just not stop. We just keep going. But this is another tune from the Great Big World album that had a full band on it, and we're gonna do it in the stripped down duo style. We're fully clothed, but just to be clear, as you can plainly see, we have our striped socks, right? Do you have your striped socks on there?
Yeah, I got the memo.
Yeah. Socks alike, I mean, you know. Sometimes we get into these fancy socks thing. I've got some Abraham Lincoln socks and some Godzilla socks where he's destroying a whole city.
Yeah, I have some robot.
You got some, yeah. And we send these through email to each other sometimes. We call it sock sting. It's like the latest. That was sort of a joke. Anyway, it has nothing to do with this next song. There's a lot going on in it.
Yeah, it's got all the fancy chords.
And all the notes, too.
Which reminds me, well, there's a good one chord blues and then the intermission there. And this is the kind of the king of, well, here we go with more honorific titles. the one chord blues, Junior Kimbrough is my nomination here for that. Great North Mississippi guy. There's this, he did this interview with him. He was talking about all them fancy songs with four or five chords in them. When I find another chord, I save it for another song.
Yeah.
It's not at all like this one.
Not at all like this one at all.
All right.
Thank you.
Said one chord is great, two chords you're pushing it, three chords it's jazz. Just for an addendum to that last one. I guess that was jazz right there. So, Bon Appétit?
Yeah.
Okay, we'd like to do another song without vocals right now.
Yeah.
Hey.
What? You guys are getting a mob mentality here. Heading south. Well, I'm happy, but I don't know.
I could use a break anyhow. You know?
This is another one from the double banjo album. It's called Bon Appétit Blues. And the tune before took like hours. And what got more applause? This last one. You see? Why work so hard?
It's an inverse relationship. Yeah.
Three chords today.
All right, we're going to leave you with a three chord song here. It's been a pleasure to sing and play for you. And I want to thank again Jalopy for nursing us. And I hope you'll join us next week. Alex Hargraves and Dominic Leslie and Larry Cook, beautiful band. I believe we're going to do some Glen Campbell honoring. They don't know this yet, but they've already agreed to the gig, and so
they're stuck.
They're stuck, yes. Yeah. And let's see, what else?
How's the weather tomorrow? What's...
Yeah. We were playing in Westchester in September.
Yeah, in September.
For the Ben Fest. Ben Fries is this really wonderful banjo player who very active promoting shows and playing music and recording music. And he passed away not too long ago, so there's a festival in his honor at the Westchester Bluegrass Club. And maybe the third week in September.
Something like that, yeah. It'll be on our website. So
yeah, yeah.
It'll
be there. And
then one more week after next week is your special guest.
That's right.
Right.
We'll be here, yeah.
So thank you all for coming out tonight.
Thank you. And thank you. Join us online, too, if you're interested in learning about any of this music we're doing. And, you know, Tony teaches banjo, and I teach bluegrass vocals on artistworks.com. I'm sure I have some cards with me, and maybe you have some stash in your case, but...
And you still have some merchandise left, right?
It definitely didn't all get sold, and unless it's been stolen. Be back there by the counter. But thank you again, and once again, give it up for Tony Trischka.
I just have to say, I ran into this guy about 8 years ago. I was playing this bluegrass festival somewhere in the middle of Manhattan.
It was the Tompkins Square.
Tompkins.
It was the Howl Festival.
Yeah, and I'd never heard of this guy before. And I was playing kind of with this group Skyline that I used to play with. And I went backstage and heard this guy and went, "Who are you? With a voice like that and guitar playing? How long have you lived here?" "Oh, 7 years." I mean, I could have been playing with you all this time. So, this guy's totally amazing. One of my favorite people. And musicians. Michael Gray.
This song, I got to keep on nerding out. I love the story about it. This song we're about to do was the first million-selling country record. Cut in 1928 by Vernon Dalhart. Who lived in Brooklyn Heights. So, you know, this is where we're like at the epicenter of country music. Right here.
Which is sort of our event today.
Over these prison walls I will fly.
much. It's really awkward. There's no like backstage. We kind of go down these deep stairs. Thank you so much.
The last song, the title of the last song?
The Prisoner's Song.
Prisoner's Song.
And it's recorded by Bill Monroe with piano, I think. It has the crazy. If you get a chance, the original recording of this from 53 or 54. Bill Monroe was not just a strict bluegrass guy, as we know. And there were times when he played with electric guitar. I think there's electric guitar on here, too. Guitar and piano.
And drums.
And his solo on here, not his, but Bill Monroe's original solo, is one of the scariest, most amazing anythings you've ever heard in music. If you ever get a chance to check it out, it's somewhere on the line, as they say, on the information superhighway. You can find it.
Compositions
in honor of this very New York City. And what we do in here, which is kind of a very special thing on these instruments, is we have what is sometimes called chimes, but it's this kind of sound here. And at the end of each solo, the soloist plays some of these things. Saying you should, but generally there's a huge hue and cry from the audience. huge applause because of the great difficulty and panache.
People have started moshing at it, mosh pits have formed and resulted in giant.
And one time Michael actually was doing these harmonics and he jumped off the stage with his guitar on.
That's right.
And nobody was there. It was really kind of sad.
Please don't throw your panties to family establishment.
It's in fact called the New York Chimes. Let's go. Four chords, no wonder. One, two, three.